again.
God be with you. What can I do for you?
Is there someone here who trades in goods?
Drivotova. He's as thin as a starving hound and about as cheerful. But he can get anything you want. I saw him by the local granary.
Goodbye.
Good afternoon.
May the Lord watch over you.
Someone there.
Thank you.
Good day to you. What do you need? Good luck to you.
Good afternoon.
Take care. Clear off before I call a catchhold.
Good day to you. What do you need?
Good luck, then.
Jesus Christ be praised.
How are the Talmberg folk getting on? Is it peaceful here?
Things here are not too bad at all. Good luck to you.
I'd like to discuss the price.
Aye.
What do you say to this?
I'd almost shake on that. Almost.
You're flaying me here.
I'd almost shake on that. Almost.
I'll go for that.
God be with you. Good luck to you.
Good afternoon.
Take care.
What? Show yourself. Who is it? God be with you. Do you need anything?
May the Lord watch over you.
Good day to you. What do you need?
I'd like you to show me some hunting tricks.
Certainly.
I'd like to practice the basics.
All right, but it'll cost you.
Maybe another time.
Good luck to you.
on out there.
Like they've already gone. Oh, God. Sweet Jesus, it's the charcoal burner. Hey!
Get going then, but leave that weapon right where it is.
Very well.
did anyone do this? What did these poor souls ever do to them?
Who's there?
What's that?
You're in the wrong place at the wrong time.
Death!
Can't hide from me.
What's the matter? Come on! Gone weak at the knees, have you?
You're not going anywhere, aren't you? Leave your weapon on the ground and get lost.
I agree.
now. This one's come crawling out from under some rock.
With a sword in his hand. You stood by his side and he did this to you. In the end, you were a hero. You didn't run away, didn't abandon him like me. It wasn't supposed to be you, Bianca. I'll find the bastards that did this to you. I'll find them. I swear it. Just wait a moment. I'll take care of my parents, and then I'll come back for you. I won't leave you like this.
Why did he do it to me, Father? Why? Why did you leave me? Forgive me. Forgive me for everything. Next time I won't run. I'll never run away again. His face. I'll find him. But first, I have to find the shovel and take care of you. I remember you told me you wanted to lie beside Mother. Here, under the linden tree. At least I can do that much for you.
Get away, you mutt! Get away, you beast!
What's going on? Bishak, what in God's name are you doing?
What do you think I'm doing? Digging turnips? The beast just went for me!
Isn't that mutt the butcher's? And isn't that body the butcher's?
Yeah, that's him.
What's that got to do with anything?
Seems to me that dog knows exactly why he's going for you. You're picking dead men's pockets.
What do you care what I'm doing? What are you doing?
Came to bury my parents.
So bury them and leave me.
Do you know what happened to Teresa from the mill? When I fled, the Cumans wanted... They meant to violate her. God knows what else.
No, I don't know. What do I care? They probably raped her and killed her like all the others. Her misfortune. Right now, I've got to take care of myself.
How did you manage to get away?
How do you think? I ran.
If you lend me that spade, I have to dig a grave and I can't find another.
What's it worth to you? I see you have a fine sword. I'll gladly trade you my spade for that. How did you come by it, anyway?
My father forged it for Sir Radzik. It's my duty to deliver it to him. It's not for sale.
Go right ahead and dig that grave with your sword. See how that is. And where will you dig it anyway? Here? You're not going to lay your parents on unhallowed ground, are you?
Father said he wanted to be buried here, and I can't take him to St. James's. God willing, later I can find a priest to consecrate the ground. I've interrupted you robbing the dead. Is that why you're so ill-tempered? You bastard. Haven't you got a shred of honor?
And what of it? The butcher has no more need of corn. And now that I think of it, your sword would do me quite nicely as well. Will you hand it over without a fuss, or do you want to end up like the butcher here?
The only way you'll touch this sword is when I shove it in your guts.
So that's for you? You know what I'm for, huh? Well, this isn't the end, fucker!
I've got business to take care of here first. God, how I wish to be gone from this place. First, I must bury my parents. Easy, Edward. You know me. Your good master won't be leaving this anymore. This is a good place. You're gonna like it.
So. Let's get to it. Damn it all. How am I going to do this?
Do you need some help?
Is that him?
Yes. Can't you see the sword?
Who are you? What do you want?
It's Bishek?
Who do you think we are? Franciscan brothers? We're here to rob you of everything you've got. Especially that fine blade that's of no use to a peasant like you anyway.
Banish the thought. It is my father's sword.
You mean him? I don't think he's going to be needing it. Listen here, boy. You hand over that sword, I might just let you go. If not, you're in for a family reunion you really don't want.
Leave me alone.
Kill him, Runt! I cut the bastard down.
As you like. Could have just cost you a few teeth.
Now.
Fuck it.
I told you how it would end. You should have listened to me. This is nice work. The chief is going to like it. It's new, isn't it? Now, for the maiden bloodletting. Surely your father never would have imagined it would be your blood. I believe there's a word for such moments. The old man would certainly know. But I'm just a common killer. Did you help make it? No doubt you did. Such miserable luck. To die by the sword you helped forge.
Hey, go fuckers! The games are over.
Thank you.
És pont mikor kedvem lenne valakiből kiverni.
Need some help?
Wake up, Henry. It's past sunrise.
Henry, can you hear me?
Get up, Henry. Wake up. It's a new day.
Henry, can you hear me? Hallelujah. I thought you'd never wake. Were you having a nightmare?
Teresa?
I still have a fever. Uncle won't be pleased, but you'll have to stay in bed.
Where am I? In Scalitz?
We're at my uncle's mill in Rattay. I didn't know where else to go.
What happened?
You don't remember anything? I suppose that's not surprising. I found you in Scalitz after those bandits attacked you. I thought they'd done for you, but you were still breathing. Why in heaven's name did you go back there? It was madness. They slaughtered everyone who didn't run.
My parents, I wanted to bury them. I had to...
Don't worry. I took care of it.
Thank you.
Any good Christian would have done the same. Now sleep. You need your strength back. You're awake.
Good morning.
It's near midnight. You've slept all day.
I feel like a horse fell on me.
The beating you took was worse. But at least the fever's broken.
How did you manage to save me?
You were lucky. I was in Scalitz and I saw Zbyszek and his thugs. I tried to distract them, but it would have been no use if those soldiers from Tamburg hadn't arrived. They were searching for you and scattered the bandits.
Searching for me?
Yes. Lord Divish sent them, led by Captain Robard. So tell me, why is a lord of such high standing interested in a blacksmith?
Sir Divish promised Sir Radzik he'd look after me. But as for why they should care, I've no idea. What in the world were you doing in Scalitz?
Waiting to die.
What?
They killed my brothers, my family, my friends.
They're all dead.
All of them. Everyone I ever loved. They killed one of my brothers in the mines.
After that, what did I have to live for?
Don't say that. There's always hope.
No, there isn't. But it doesn't matter.
I'm a different person now.
Ugh, I'm exhausted.
I'm not surprised. I'll bring you water and something to eat. In the meantime, rest. You're still very weak. Good morning to you. How's the invalid today?
Ugh, I haven't felt as good as this since they lashed me to the wheel and quartered me on the town square.
Got your sense of humour back. You must be better. My uncle will be glad to hear it. I had a job persuading him to let me bring you here. If you'd lain around much longer, he really would have dumped you on the town square. You can stay until you find somewhere else to live, but my uncle will want payment for taking you in and caring for you.
And this is your uncle's house?
We're in Rattay Mill. My uncle's Miller Peshek. He took me in, and I talked him into taking care of you too.
I've been lying here long enough.
Uncle will be pleased he's one mouth less to feed. But are you truly well enough?
Well enough to do what has to be done. Where can I find Sir Radzig?
He's in the lower castle in Perkstein. He's a guest of Sir Hanish of Leipa. But someone like you can't just walk up bold as you please and demand an audience.
I know Sir Radzig, and I didn't bring him his sword as I was supposed to. I must see him.
If you insist. But you need to speak to my uncle first. You've been in your sickbed for over a fortnight while he paid the apothecary to tend to you, and for medicine. That's a good deal of a coin you owe him.
I've been lying here 2 weeks. My God.
Better a fortnight in bed than an eternity in the grave. If it weren't for my uncle, you wouldn't be here at all.
I owe you both my life, and I'll repay my debt. You have my word.
All right. But before you go to town, you should eat something. You're still weak. There's food on the table for you.
Thank you.
Have you eaten yet?
Yes, it was very good. Did you bake it yourself?
I did. I'm glad you enjoyed it. Henry, I'm so glad to see you.
A word with you, young fellow.
My name's Henry. Thank you for taking care of me here.
My name's Peshek, and I'm the miller here. You've already met my niece, Teresa. She took care of you for 2 whole weeks while you were in limbo, and talking of you being at death's door. While you were lying here, you worked up quite a bill with the bloodletter, who came now and again to keep you alive with his potions. That quack doesn't come cheap. I paid him what I could, but I still, that is, you still owe him.
I see. Well, it's better to be in debt than to lie dead in a ditch. What do I owe? I'm not afraid of hard work.
You won't pay for that shoveling manure. I might have a better job for you. Only it's not something any fool can do. If you prove to me you're a clever lad, I might trust you with something you could really make money from. What do you say?
Well, what would you need from me?
A trifle. Just to take something from someone and bring it to someone else. And not get caught while you're doing it.
That sounds straightforward enough. Except for not get caught. Why would anyone want to catch me?
Oh, don't worry. It's just a job like any other. Only this one requires, let's say, the right moral disposition. Do corpses bother you?
No honourable man should touch them. That's the executioner's job.
Did you expect I'd give you a hoe and send you out to the fields? You can dig all right, but somewhere else. I want to know whether you're going to hide behind some stupid fucking scruples, or if you might be useful for more unconventional work.
I'm not sure dealing with corpses is a job for me. I don't want that kind of stain on my conscience, or my reputation. Find someone else.
Suit yourself. I gave you a chance to work off your debt. Don't think you can wriggle out of it. I want my groschen back, and quick. Otherwise, I'll make your life hell. Believe me.
May the Lord watch over you.
Can you tell me...
What about the Scalitz folk?
God sent them to punish us for our sins. They don't work, they just idle around begging. And you want to keep a close eye on your belongings when they're around. I'll be glad to see the back of them.
What do you think about everything that's happened?
I don't concern myself with the doings of my betters. But this mess isn't good for business. Them two brothers should sort things out between themselves without dragging us into it. I don't give a damn who's king, but that usurper from Hungary has gone too far.
Do you know anything about those Cumans?
The heathen scum that Sigismund brought here. Why do you even ask? You've seen with your own 2 eyes what they're capable of.
That's all.
God be with you.
What's that dog you have here? He looks familiar.
Don't you remember him? It's Mart, the butcher's dog from Scallets.
Ah, of course. When I went back to bury my parents, he was guarding his master's dead body. A faithful dog. How come he's here?
When we carted you here, we took Mart along too. He's been hanging around the mill ever since.
How's he doing?
A lot better now. I slipped him something good now and again when Uncle wasn't looking.
He won't starve to death then. What does the miller have to say about it?
He can't stand him.
How's that?
Every time he sees him, he starts shouting that he's a useless mouth to feed and that he'll skin him.
Jesus.
And it didn't even soften his heart when Mutt brought a hare from the woods. He was happy to eat it, but it didn't change his mind.
I could have a word with him.
That would be a waste of time.
Does he obey you?
Me? Not much. He's got a mind of his own, and I'm just not strict enough.
Ah, spoilt then.
No, he just hasn't learned many commands. But he's well able to beg for a piece of meat.
How long has he been with you?
More or less since we came here. He runs off now and again, but he always comes back. Sometimes I don't see him all day. I think he likes to go wandering.
So he's doing quite well then?
Yeah. I'd keep him, but he reminds me too much of Tinker, you know? I don't want to think about Scallet. So I thought maybe you might take him with you?
Me?
I'm sure the two of you would get on great. He's a handsome fella and lovable. I'd be very happy if you had him.
But we never had a dog at the smithy. We never needed one.
Come on. He's got no one.
All right. I'll take him. He can keep me company on my travels.
Thanks, Henry. Go and get him then. He's sniffing around somewhere here.
Hey, Mutt. Remember me? From Scallets, remember? Wanna go with me? Come on then, we'll get on like a house on fire. Follow me. Me? Look what I've got for you. You'll love this.